Hello, everyone. My name is Anshul, and I'm a part of Azure Identity team in Microsoft. This video is a tutorial on troubleshooting synchronization issues in Azure AD Connect. Today, we will be focusing on resolving issues with a single contact in your environment. Before we go through an example for troubleshooting, there are a couple of things we need to take care of when syncing a contact. Contact must satisfy the following condition in order to be synchronized. Contact object in AD should be a mail-enabled group with a valid email address. The display name of the contact should not be blank in on-premises Active Directory. The mail attribute should not be blank. And of course, there should not be any conflicting or duplicate object already present with a similar email address in Azure Active Directory. Let's start with the demo. We have this contact, contact one, created in local Active Directory. But this contact is not visible in Office 365. So we go to Azure AD Connect and we search for this contact in the metaverse. We can use display name or mail attribute for metaverse search. Now let's go to the properties of this contact and we can see that there's only AD connector which is present. The cloud connector is missing. Now one thing to note here is that a connector is created only when the provisioning sync rule is applied for a particular object. This indicates that the contact is in sync scope, but provisioning rule is not applied for the cloud connector. When we see the properties of this object, we also see that cloud filtered is set to true. Let's see why the value is set to true here. If we see the sync rule applied for this object, we can see it is in from AD contact join rule, which is contributing towards the cloud filter attribute. Let's go to the sync rule editor and validate the transformation. We can apply filters for connector and metaverse object type. Let's go to the sync rule in from AD contact join. As we can see, the rule type here is provision. And when we go to the transformation, what we are looking here is for the cloud filter transformation. In order to simplify this expression, let's take this in a notepad file to understand what's going on. The conditions are made up of several logical tests that check if values are present or meet certain criteria. So for example, the test involves here checking the value for is critical system object. If it is present, or if the display name contains MSOL and the value for MSEXCH hide from address list is true, or if mail nickname starts with CAS underscore and also contains a curly bracket, or there's a particular string in the attribute DN. If any of these conditions are true, the expression will return true, otherwise it will return null. Let's go to on-premises Active Directory attributes of the contact in question and evaluate these attributes. You can see here the display name starts with MSOL. At the same point in time, MSEXCH hide from address list has been set to true. So let's make the necessary corrections. And in our case, we will just change the display name and remove MSOL from the display name of the contact. Now we will run a delta sync manually using the following PowerShell command. Let's go back to the synchronization service again. And we can notice that the sync cycle is complete. We refresh the metaverse search. The display name is updated. And we can also see the cloud filter attribute is not present in the attributes anymore. Also, we can now see that the cloud connector has also been created for this object. When we look into the export operation, we can see one adds happening, which is basically the contact that we've just created or modified. Let us also evaluate the same thing in the Office 365 Admin Center. We can see that the contact has been synchronized. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope this has been helpful in resolving any synchronization issues in your environment.